So you made up your mind and decided to move your whole family across the country right here to St. George, Utah. Now what? Where do we start? What is the best place to live in St. George, Utah? This video might be a great place for you to start because today we're going to discuss what constitutes the best neighborhoods right here in St. George, Utah. We'll take you on a drive to check out these neighborhoods in person, and we'll even take you into a couple of homes in these neighborhoods so you could get a better idea of what it would be like if you were right here, boots on the ground. Hopefully you're doing your research ahead of time, or maybe if you're in too far already, just give us a call. We'll be happy to point you in the right direction. Without further ado, let's dive into it and discuss a little bit of what we think makes a neighborhood one of the best neighborhoods right here in St. George, Utah. Now, don't just take my word for it. We came up with this comprehensive list of what makes it a great place to live after asking a couple of our clients that previously moved here. And most of them agreed that there are several factors that go into any place being a great place to live. Convenience, schools, utilities, safety, and value/resale value of the property. Now, I want to talk a little bit about school districts. I find it that in various stages of our life, maybe you have children, maybe you're single and no children, maybe the children are out of your house. The whole school district thing may be more prevalent to some in terms of utility. Like if you have children, you want to be in the best school district. And it seems like all the other categories tend to often disregard this. But let's go back to the last point of value and resale. Right here in St. George, Utah, there's one school district that is very, very prominent for the resale value and property value in general. So if you stick around this video, we're going to cover what school district that might be and how to make sure that you purchase a home with the best resale value that often spends up to 50% fewer days on the market compared to the rest of Washington County. So let's talk a little bit about geography. If you're watching this video, chances are you have probably already started your research, or maybe not, maybe you're completely brand new. Let's talk a little bit about location. So St. George, Utah is located in the southwestern corner of Utah, backing up to Arizona and Nevada border. This is where today's video is going to take place. Now, how do we determine the best school district in this area? I don't want you to take my word for it because this is important and it requires somebody with a bit more experience, with a bit more data, somebody that could compile a comprehensive scorecard, somebody that could tell you more from peers, more from students and teachers, what is the best school district. So with that being said, internet comes to the rescue. Niche.com is a website that compiles these comprehensive rankings, and in our case, even a full report card. So Washington County School District is ranked number 13 in the best school districts in Utah. In order to land on this rating, they considered several factors like academics, teachers, clubs and activities, sports, resources and facilities, diversity, college prep, administration, food. I'm not going to bore you guys with too much info, too many details. I will just link in the description below this video to this website. So those of you that are still conducting your own research can go and follow this link and check it out. Now, I want to point out one thing before we get away from this topic. How do we determine which schools are the best? Well, conveniently, niche.com provided us with rankings for some of the best schools right here in St. George, Utah. There is one thing that's in common across the board. If we look at elementary schools, Crimson View School is the best elementary school that received an A minus rating. If we look at middle schools, Crimson Cliffs Middle received an A rating. And if we look at high schools, Crimson Cliffs High School is also dominating the scorecard. So it is evident that you want to be in Crimson boundaries if you want to be in the best school boundaries right here in St. George, Utah. How do we determine what Crimson boundaries are? Now, I will also provide a link to this website because for whatever reason, I find that Washington County makes this a little bit more complicated than some of the other places I've lived, but I will link this below so you could check it out for yourself as you're making this selection. Crimson Cliffs High School is the purple that you see on a map right here. So the boundary kind of follows the map and it starts halfway through Little Valley and it goes up a little further north, partly into Washington Fields. Now, remember these neighborhoods, Little Valley and Washington Fields are two of the prominent St. George neighborhoods that may ring a bell later on as you see our videos and as we go on these neighborhood tours and show you guys what it is like to live there, boots on the ground sort of perspective. So those are the boundaries. And another thing that may be important for you, especially if you're looking at purchasing a larger home, perhaps a home with a pool or just overall larger square footage that you like to keep cool in the summertime, it is the cost of utilities. One thing that's very interesting is how the map of Dixie Power sort of coincides with their coverage map, coincides almost ideally with the school boundaries. Now, if you're anywhere in the area that is blue on this map, and I'll provide a link to this as well so you could follow along, that is where you get 6 cents per kilowatt. That's right. Dixie Power is in the top three of the most affordable power companies in the nation, and we sure hope it stays that way. So enough about that. Let's get out of this office. Let's hit the road and let's go check out some of these neighborhoods and some of the homes in person. All right. Let's talk a little bit about the demographics of this area. So if you're considering moving into Crimson Boundaries, and this will include quite a few neighborhoods, it's kind of hard to include the entire list of all the neighborhoods because it's a lot. It's a good portion of like Little Valley area, good portion St. George and Washington. So I was able to pull these stats up kind of give you guys an idea on some of the demographics. People that live here share some common traits and occupations, and I don't know exactly how these stats got pulled, but at least according to this website that we use that's available to us through MLS, like there's a large amount of people that work in healthcare and social assistance. Then next up, accommodations and food, education, manufacturing. I don't know where we've got people in manufacturing jobs. But there's also a great deal of entrepreneurs and people that transferred into this area with employment in remote locations. Cost of real estate in this area kind of ranges anywhere. So our entry level listing that fits into the Crimson Boundary that we featured in this video is at $450,000. And I think the current most expensive is somewhere in the range of like
$4 million.
I feel like it's actually higher.
There probably is higher. I just selected what homes were vacant and easy to show, but
and we'll include a list for you guys for those of you that are curious, and if you would like to see what are the price ranges, I will put a link in the description below this video that will give you all listings in all price ranges that you can get your hands on at Crimson Boundary. And of course, we'll always tell you that you will not make a mistake by moving to St. George, Utah. You can only make a mistake by moving into the wrong subdivision. Now, if you shoot us a text, give us a call, email us, just tell us a couple things about yourself and about your unique set of needs. We'll be sure to pair you with the right neighborhood and, you know, perhaps the right school district, even if Crimson Boundary might not be for you. However, this video is about Crimson, so let's talk a little bit more about the demographics that occupy Crimson Boundaries. Average income per capita is $74,000. Median household income is at $144,000. So, you know, if you look at these price ranges, you know, the general dynamics of the price ranges within the school boundaries kind of dictate that, you know, you do have to have that income to support real estate purchases in this area. Let's talk a little bit about drivability and convenience. As you guys see, most of these listings that we're featuring in today's video are no more than like 5 minutes away from school. You're about how far away? On average, 5 to 10 minutes away from Costco.
Yeah.
About 5 minutes away from
like other surrounding grocery stores.
Surrounding grocery stores.
5 to less than 10 minutes away from any gym. On Dixie Power.
You're like about 5 minutes away from my favorite gym in Southern Utah, Fitness Culture.
Summit Athletic Club is another great gym in this area, and you're again no more than 10 minutes away from Summit. You're no more than 10 minutes away from desert and mountain bike trails, off-road trails.
Yeah, from here you could just get on your dirt bike and your side-by-side and you would be on the trails in literally probably 5 minutes.
5 minutes, yeah. That's another big commonly asked question by a lot of our clients is I have to put my stuff in a trailer. Well, the beautiful thing about Southern Utah and St. George, Utah is if you have a road legal side-by-side, meaning it's got blinkers, it's got the full, like Can-Am's and Polaris often will sell you a side-by-side. If you don't yet have one, but you plan on moving here and you plan on purchasing one, you absolutely should. You could purchase it with a street legal kit, meaning it has a set of blinkers, headlights, taillights, and a license plate mount. So you could take it anywhere and you could drive it just like a regular vehicle. You just cannot take it on the highway. Hence the reason they sell it in the OHV. They call it an OHV, so off-highway vehicle.
But if you're in Crimson Boundaries, there really is no need to trailer your stuff. Right. You're right next to the trail.
You're like 10 minutes away from Arizona Strip. Once you get to the Arizona Strip, you could access like three different states without ever hitting a paved road. And the same thing goes for dirt bikes. So if you've got a dirt bike, it's pretty rare that you would have to like ever trailer it. But enough about that. Let's check out some more of these awesome homes that we prepared for you guys.
Hi guys. So we are here at the foothills of St. George subdivision, and we just wanted to give you a tour of a few different price points homes of what you can expect to find in the Crimson Boundaries. This home is going to be in the entry level price point of Crimson Boundaries. This home is priced at $450,000. We're going to go check it out, but first I want to give credit due to the listing agent Bob Richards with Berkshire Hathaway. And this home is a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom. It's 1,781 square feet. It sits on a 0.18-acre lot, and this home has no HOA. We're just gonna check out a few different price points in Crimson Boundaries, but we are including a link in the description below this video with all the listings in Crimson Boundaries so you can check out for yourself. This home was built, what did you remember the year?
1993,
okay. But it looks like this home has had a full remodel with LVP flooring, new paint, granite countertops. Let's go check it out. So you come in, this is the living area.
Sitting room, living room, what would you guys call this?
Yeah, because there's a family room in here, kind of a living area in here.
And it's a relatively common theme with like the 1990s and older plans in Southern Utah that you'll find this like, you have like two living rooms basically.
Yeah, there's like several different sitting rooms before you get to like the main house. And right in here we have the kitchen, dining area. It's like they did granite countertops, new single stainless steel sink. Let's go check out some of the bedrooms. Looks like right here we have access to the 2-car garage.
Exactly, a bedroom.
The light's not turning on, so.
Let me show you guys. It's a really good size 2-car garage.
A couple of these lights are not working. And in here we have the primary bedroom, and you have access to the backyard for this door. Nice vaulted ceilings, which is a plus. And fully updated bathroom, which is nice. There's a pocket door right here. We have a double vanity, linen closet, and looks like they did a whole shower, tile to the ceiling remodel.
Really cool flooring choices in this house. It is gray tile through this area.
They are missing a transition piece right here.
Can we take just a moment to appreciate the fact that they got rid of the carpet in the bedroom?
Yeah.
I'm a huge fan of no carpet.
I am too. I would rather just lay out a rug and then when that goes, just get a new rug, wash the rug, like not have to deal with it, especially if you have pets. We have dogs, so we're a big fan of not having carpet.
Absolutely.
And then this is a very good size walk-in closet, and this also has a pocket door to shut away, but very spacious. pass-through shelving, which is nice. Okay, let's go check out the rest of the house. And then here we have the family room, which is just a few steps down. I'm a big fan of the vaulted ceilings. It just really opens up the space, but this is a very nice space, gas fireplace. Okay, let's go check it out. And here is our second bedroom that faces the front of the home.
Carpet in here.
Carpet in here, new carpet at that. Okay, and onto our third bedroom. And this home does have quite a bit of storage, which is nice, so. And we have a laundry room right here. The washer and dryers are pulled out, but it's a decent sized laundry room.
I like the wallpaper.
Yeah. And then full bathroom right here.
Sorry, it's a bring your kids to work day.
Hey, whatever it takes, right? And here is our third bedroom. Okay, let's go check out the backyard. Come on, sis, let's go check it out. Big step. Got some nice covered patio back here. It's actually pretty good size. Looks like they have some pull down shades. It's a desert landscaping and we've got some nice mature trees. What do you guys think? Would you consider this home for $450,000?
There are actually several other listings in this neighborhood. We just wanted to spotlight this one because it was easy to show, it's vacant. And we feel that it would make a pretty good value proposition if you're looking to be in the right school district. Maybe you have one of those or a couple of them running around and you're looking for a good entry point that will have great future resale. And personally, I'm always a big fan of entry-level homes in good school districts because you may outgrow that property, but the demand will probably never fall.
And this home is centrally located, so you're literally 5 minutes away from any shopping that you would need. And if you're a big fan of grabbing yourself a drink, there is a drink shop. Just
a drink? What do people from other states don't understand what you're talking about?
Like a soda shop.
What's a soda shop?
Pop shop. I don't know. That, like, we have so many on every corner here. I think it's called Fizz. I think that's the name of this drink shop around the corner. But it's a 5 minute walk or probably a 2 minute drive. So
people probably still don't understand. A drink shop is, I think, mostly a Utah thing where they drink a concoction of soda with other flavors.
Like they have like every flavor you can imagine. And so they've got all these different names of different soda drinks. So you can add any kind of soda of your choice and then they'll add like vanilla or orange flavoring, cherry, anything. So yeah.
Anyway, if that's your thing, you could get one just a few minutes away from this house. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now in Hawkeye Point. So this subdivision is even closer to Crimson Schools. We're literally a short walk away, as you can see from the B-roll footage in this video. I would like to thank Ray Cox for giving us an opportunity for touring this home. And Ray had one condition. He said that I had to admit that he is the best looking realtor in Washington County. Think that could be debatable. I will leave that up to you guys. Please drop us a comment below. And you know, he said another thing that's arguable is possibly better looking than Michonne's husband. So you guys let me know. Do I win in this category? Does Ray win in this category? Anyway, let's take a closer look at this listing. This home is 3,711 square feet, so it is quite large. This listing is available at the time of this video, and I will post a link in the description below so you can come and check it out in person or get more info for yourself. This property is a two-level home. It was built in 2015 and it sits on a 0.2 acre lot. I feel like this is a great example of a deal that you could get right now in 2024. And I'm really actually quite glad to see these deals come to market. It is a two-story home, so as you walk in, we'll go back and give you guys a shot of that, but as you walk in, this hallway takes you into the living room. And what I really love about this plan is that the living room has this nice open vault that goes all the way up to the second story. And then it kind of flows into
the kitchen. You see me dodge that light?
Yeah.
This is a first for me. Normally I hit those lights. So the light is hung perfectly at 6 feet, 3 inches. I happen to be 6'2". And if you follow me across this room, you have this nice open kitchen. And actually, just hold on, just come over there.
Okay.
And I don't want to blow the surprise. I love to eat. So if you love to eat, Michonne and I cook probably 98% of our meals at home. And if you cook majority of your meals at home, you have a higher demand for storage for your leftovers. So this property has not one, but two refrigerators. There's a cafe series fridge right here, right next to your wall oven and the microwave. Beautiful granite countertops. I actually really like this color of granite. It's not too busy and it's nice and gray and it kind of matches everything else in this kitchen. The second fridge, let's check out this pantry. So this home has a pass-through butler pantry with a second full-size Bosch refrigerator. And this pantry takes you back out into this hallway. How do you feel about this? This is almost like a hallway pantry.
I like it. It's nice and hidden.
Where do you put your food? So you've got your cabinets right here. You've got storage in the cabinets.
Like, this is a full pantry where you put all your food in here.
It's basically a full-on pantry.
But it's nice because it's clean and it's not open shelving, so it's just kind of tucked away.
Yeah. I don't know. Some people could be possibly a little torn on this because I feel like you're more used to like traditional open shelving that could arguably store more, but this is really neat.
Well, and look how much shelving the kitchen has. Like,
so you have this door takes you into the garage. And this is just your single bay, which is actually kind of cool because it's completely disconnected. If you have a beautiful classic car, sports car, whatever it is, a couple of bikes, whatever you want to keep protected. Maybe you're sharing garage with kids. You could lock it away completely so that nobody touches your 56 Chevy. Now this is the garage that you could use for the whole family. You could fit two cars in here comfortably. All of your water heater, 80 gallon water heater, water softener, your furnace, all of the equipment is in here. And man, for 2015, this home is in really great shape. Let me just double check that it is 2015.
No, it's 2023. Pretty sure.
No, you're built 2015. I don't know where you found 2023.
I am losing my mind.
Yes. This patio door opens up to the side yard. Now this home sits in a relatively small lot. It's a 3,700 square foot home that they were able to fit on a 0.2 acre lot. Not a very big lot. We'll take a look at the backyard in just a moment. I love the fact that they have a sliding door on this side that if Michonne backs up a little, it'll be a little easier to see. It takes you out into the side yard. You have room for a barbecue, nice little patio back here, even though the backyard is not huge. The living room has a nice touch with the fireplace, nice little sitting area. Let's just go back towards the front so we'll finish exploring the first floor and then we'll head upstairs.
Oh, you missed a bedroom right here. The primary bedroom.
Okay. So front door, staircase that takes you upstairs. Under stairs, storage area, nice and large. Directly behind me, we have a powder room. And this is your front bedroom that could easily become an office. We're shooting this video mid-afternoon, so the afternoon sun is really, really pleasant. I feel like it lights up the front of the house and there's plenty of flow through the house. What I mean by that is you have, throughout most of the first floor, you have windows on both sides, which is so, so important when you live in a desert. We deal with bright sun here all the time. And if you're looking at houses and they happen to look just kind of dark, it's most likely because the home only has windows on one side of the house. As you see here, we got plenty of afternoon sun from the front of the property, and we still have plenty of light from the back of the property. As we make our way back, your primary bedroom sits on the rear of the property. You've got massive windows throughout this back wall. And even though the backyard is not huge, stop repeating it, it feels nice and secluded, and it feels like it's got plenty of space for activities back there. We'll go out there in just a moment. This room is carpeted. you could comfortably fit a king size bed on this side. And I'm pretty good space, like half a football field away from Michonne. So you've got all sorts of room for activities in here. Beautiful tile on the floor. I am a huge fan of this color combination. Really well executed on the corner tub, really good size tub. Dual vanity shower with some really cool tile throughout the entire shower. Only a single shower head though. I feel like that shower could accommodate two. And holy closet space, take a look at this. So this closet goes off to this side. And normally that would be what you would expect in a home this size for a closet, but wait, there's more. The second wing of this closet is just as large. And then what was the deal with that set of double doors? If you back up a little.
Just check it out.
Follow me over here. So you've got a spot for a washer and dryer right in your primary bed. Is that your only laundry room in this house?
Nope. There's more.
There's more.
How weird would it be? Everyone comes into the primary closet. It
is so cool. I can't
laundry.
Believe this home was built in 2015 because it has so many features that we see in parade homes and modern day homes. Like when I say modern day, like homes that are 10 years newer. This home is way, way, way ahead of its time. So this gives us everything to explore on the main floor. Let's head upstairs and see what we'll find there. Really nice open staircase. Doesn't feel like it's boxed off, which is a huge design touch. So in a property this size, 3,700 square feet, you will most likely need the room for more family members, perhaps children. They can have their own laundry room. It is upstairs. Majority of the laundry makers are gonna occupy the bedrooms upstairs. So the source of this laundry is gonna come from these bedrooms. This bedroom has an ensuite, really nice and spacious. And the ensuite bath has a single vanity, tile flooring, nice shower tub combo. Directly behind you have a closet. That's a pretty good sized closet.
See.
I'm not going to the closet, I'm sorry.
Because then you'll have to.
Been out a long time. Not like, you know what I mean. This little loft area is a really good size, could be a second living room. For those of you that have children, you could appreciate the fact of having your children upstairs. Always kind of lets you know what they're up to. If they get quiet, you gotta worry. This is the front upstairs bedroom. Again, huge. Really nice, tall. 9-foot ceilings, 8-foot doors in this house. And that makes a huge difference. Good sized closet with some nice built-ins. As we traverse down this hallway back here, you have a bath, if you want to go in and check it out. This bath is shared between these two bedrooms. And this rear upstairs bedroom is also very, very generously sized. You got nice plantation shutters throughout. This is a really premium touch. You got views of the red butte, what do you call those things?
The mountain?
Yeah, it's not really a mountain. What do you guys call that? Butte, how do you pronounce it? Lived here for over 10 years. I should probably know it by now. Okay, let's go out in the backyard and see what that is all about. Now that I have mentioned that it is not very large, I'm curious to actually see it in person. Those of you that are touring this home with us, Michonne was able to run through and turn on the lights, so this is literally my first time going through this house. Have we looked what's behind this door?
Coat
More
closet.
Storage, coat closet. Now, this home is plumbed for the whole house vac, which is
central vac.
Central vac is a really cool touch. A lot of luxury touches in this house. I really, really, really like it. Now, another big thing, if you're designing a custom home, maybe you're building a home right now, see there's a sliding door to the right that will take you out in the backyard. And there's also a regular man door to the left. From personal experience, if all you have is a sliding door to access your backyard, can become quite annoying. I feel like these doors are a lot more functional. If you're running back and forth, you're barbecuing, these doors are great if you're trying to turn it into an indoor-outdoor space. So for everyday use, all day, every day. Okay. This back wall, we used me as a measuring stick earlier, so you can't say that realtors are useless. This is what 6'2" looks like against this back wall. So you've got, what, at like least 10, two more courses of bricks like above
foot,
me?
Yeah.
Each brick is 8 inches, you guys do the math. 6'2" plus 16, five maybe? Okay.
And this is turf?
This is artificial turf. Now, another big pointer if you're relocating to Southern Utah, your backyard happens to look like this, the grass will not grow here. So
if it's super shaded?
Super hot, super shaded, grass doesn't grow. Artificial turf does not care. Your 5-ton HVAC unit back there, little gravel section, and wow, for a smaller backyard, for a 0.2 acre lot and almost a 4,000 square foot home, this is incredible. This little walkway takes us onto the concrete patio area. I feel like this space could use a little pergola or gazebo. We've got a guest stub. That sliding door takes you into the kitchen. It looks like the window has some factory tint on it, which is awesome. And you've got all sorts of side parking over here. So, 3-car garage, extra side parking, all sorts of square footage for all sorts of activities and all sorts of people in your family. What more could you possibly ask for? Let me know what you guys think about this listing. I think that it punches a good value for this price range to be in the best school boundaries. Link is in the description below. Let's check out the next house.
So we are at our next home that we would like to tour. This is in a brand new subdivision called Samson Estates. And again, I would like to give thanks to the best looking real estate agent on our entire board of realtors, Ray Cox with ERA Brokers Consolidated, for allowing us to tour this home. This home is priced at $1.9 million. It is a 6-bedroom home, 6.5 bathroom, 5,536 square feet. It has a 4-car garage. It was built in 2022 and it sits on a 0.35 acre and there is no HOA. Let's go check it out.
Also, and it has a pool.
It has a pool. And so this home just hit the market today. So this home.
This is a great option if you're looking for something that's a little bit more premium and has plenty of room for your family, your toys. And of course, if you're gonna be in Southern Utah, we have some really, really hot summers and you can use that pool literally year round. Are we on Dixie Power here? We are on Dixie Power here, right?
Dixie Power.
So it doesn't cost very much to cool the house and heat the pool.
So we've got these steel doors with the see-through glass, which is beautiful.
How do you guys feel about that? Is that not enough privacy or too much door? Or is that just right?
It's been pretty trendy and pretty in, but I mean, you can always tint it if you don't love it open.
I think it looks cool.
Yeah. And we've got a nice large entryway. And then right to your left as you walk in, this could be an office or a bedroom. It does have a walk-in closet with the glass French doors opening in. The whole house has shutters on the windows. Let's go ahead and walk into the main living area, which is massive. And look at all the natural light with all the open windows. I did want to point out that right behind us is the St. George Academy. It's a 7th through 12th charter school. But other than that, I mean, it's nice and private. We've got nice built-in shelving with a gas fireplace. And this space is just beautiful.
your family room. Huge, you could put the biggest dining table here. And let's walk into the kitchen. I just took some notes. We have custom cabinetry, quartz countertops, GE Cafe appliance package, and side-by-side refrigerator and freezer, and there is a massive butler's pantry. Looks like we have two sinks, which is super nice for prepping, cooking.
Nice waterfall edge on that countertop.
Yes. And beautiful appliances. We've got double oven, which is super nice. Microwave, the monogram microwave, and the monogram, this is a six burner gas stove. And this is what I need in my life, two dishwashers.
Dual dishwasher, yes.
We literally cook everything at home, and my mom thinks we're crazy that I'm telling her that we're literally filling our dishwasher up at least once a day. And you've got a nice window right here above the sink.
So look. You've got two sinks.
Yes.
Sink number one, sink number two. Although that sink should be a standard size sink. But since this house has two dishwashers, totally forgivable.
But this sink is huge, and that's good for like prep cooking. And...
Right.
Okay. So here is our huge butler's pantry.
Oh, you're not kidding.
All the way around with plenty of shelving.
Look at all that shelving. How do you guys feel about that pantry? I feel like it is a very, very, very proper pantry.
And I'm a big fan of this blonde color cabinetry and the floors. It just, and with the white cabinetry on top, it looks very tasteful.
And the waterfall edge on that center island is just absolutely perfect.
And you've got some outlets here, extra cabinetry underneath. Beautiful. Do you want to go this way first?
Yeah.
Might as well since we're over here. Okay, so here is a generously sized laundry room. You've got your sink and plenty of cabinetry.
I love folding. The glass doors on those cabinets.
I do too. It looks beautiful.
Okay, half the people are watching this video just for the garage.
Okay, we're going to get to the garage. We've got our mudroom area. Hang up all the kids' backpacks. They have all their lockers and kick your shoes off. Plenty of room
to
put
your shoes.
Garage. Okay, let's go to the garage. Okay, before we get to the garage, so this garage is 1,800 square feet of garage space, including a 45-foot RV boat garage, and the floor has epoxy flooring.
Beautiful.
So here we have our two-car, and it's extra deep, extra wide. Shutters on the window that faces the front of the property. And it just keeps going, 1,800 square feet.
So the cool thing about the RV garage is you also have the third bay right here. So you've got your third bay that faces in the same direction as the RV garage door. The RV garage door looks like it is 12 by 14, which is exactly what you would want.
They say it's a four car on the listing, but as you can see, you can fit a lot more than four cars in this 1,800.
Absolutely massive.
And then I'm just checking this. I'm assuming this goes to the backyard.
You know what? We might as well go out there before it gets too dark.
You do? Okay, let's go check it out.
We're shooting this video in the evening towards the end of the day, so you guys get to see how cool this backyard looks. Is that a pool bath?
Yeah, cute, look. Super nice, and it's, and you can access it from the garage as well.
Those stick figures really had to go.
No, they're perfect. I love that touch. Okay. It is starting to get dark, so I hope you guys can see just how beautiful this backyard is. It is very low maintenance. As you can see, there are plenty of palm trees with beautiful landscaping lighting. We've got the turf for easy maintenance, so you don't have to worry about mowing the grass. Looks like this pool has the Shamu shelf. It's got a slot for your umbrella right there. You've got a hot tub right here. It is gorgeous. And look at all this space.
The real question is, can I make it across the sledge without falling in?
Do it again.
Okay.
Don't break a leg. Neighbors have a dog. Dog does not appreciate the trampoline.
So, trampoline works great. And what is on the side over here? So that is our primary bedroom. And you've got access to the backyard right there. Let's go check out the rest of the house.
Let's do it. Thank you for that demonstration.
You're so welcome. We just wanted to make sure that it worked. So we will go ahead and let's check this out.
Before Jimmy Kimmel.
Well, I lost it.
Before Jimmy Kimmel started to politicize his shows, it was a great show on late network cable TV called Man's Show.
Well.
It had a whole section of girls jumping on a trampoline.
For real?
It did.
Well, I missed that. This is a triple slider and it will slide all the way back, but I couldn't push it for some reason.
It might have
might be locked or something.
Might have a lock for this middle section.
Okay. Oh.
There we go.
This is a little bit stuck.
So that slides two sections, three panels fold back into one, and it gives you this cool indoor outdoor space so you could entertain your company out here. And since you have St. George Academy behind this place, you've got quite a bit of rear backyard privacy. So like, yeah, during the day, it's a school. During the night, you've got no rear neighbor.
It looks like there's built-in speakers outside, inside, and this little Hunter Douglas right here, all the blinds facing this entire, like these two big windows, the glass sliding door and the window above the kitchen sink are all electronic.
So if we hit all and close, all of your rear blinds will go down. And if you hit all and open or hit the stop button, and then hit all open. They go back up.
Awesome. Okay, and then in the middle of the kitchen and family room, we have a large under the stair storage closet. And it looks like a powder bathroom, half bathroom. And if you've got lots of storage, this is the house for you. We've got another storage closet.
Lots of things to store, rather.
And this bedroom faces the front of the home. Has a walk-in closet. Let's go check out the primary bedroom. I'm actually gonna shut this door real quick, if I can.
Demo of Michonne struggling with a sliding door. Might have to build up some momentum.
Well, maybe. Okay.
It is a very nice, high quality door with a metal frame, which is very much a key when you have a home with a sliding door in a desert and regular track maintenance, of course.
So the hallway into the primary bedroom, this wall is shiplap. Got a little coat closet right here. Another accent wall on this side of the wall. You've got your backyard access out through this door. And this room is really good size. And it looks like
size.
The Hunter Douglas again with the electronic blinds, which is nice. And the built-in speakers, the tray ceiling. We've got this sliding barn door into the primary bathroom. And check out the size of this bathroom. It is massive. We've got the double vanity with the built-ins. A light above to let that natural light in.
Who was the cougar bar singer that sings about the song is called I Want to Be a Rock Star, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Who sings it? Talks about a bathroom where you could play football in it.
This is it. Got a large soaking tub here and then a walk around shower with two shower heads.
Is it Nickelback? Did I just make a Nickelback reference?
I don't know. Did you?
We might be losing some subscribers over this comment.
Please don't click off over that comment. There is so much more to see. You're going to want to stick around till the end of this video. And if you haven't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button.
I promise I don't listen to Nickelback.
So we've got two closets and they're both massive. Huge closet. What's in here? Okay, awesome. Laundry, dirty laundry. Okay. And your water closet right here. Some more built-ins. Can't get enough storage. And then this closet with the window faces the front of the property. What do you guys think? Like, what would you do with all this room? Like, this is ridiculous.
No, it's perfect. It's just right.
Okay, let's go upstairs. Come on, keep up. Okay, now this space is, it is like half the size of a football field. We've got more Hunter Douglas electronic blinds with the shiplap accent wall. The space is huge. And you can see all of St. George from up here. I mean, you can't now because it's dark outside. We missed that boat, but let me just tell you. Okay. I need to step up my cardio game. Like, that's like one tiny flight of stairs and I'm out of breath.
Well, to your defense, you were just jumping on a trampoline like a mad woman.
That's true. Okay, so we have another great size laundry room up here. This faces the front of the property. Lots of built-ins, which is super nice.
Pause. I absolutely love this feature. And anybody that's watching this that has multiple children or has plans for more children, all the little creatures that may produce the bulk of your laundry typically live on this floor. In this house, they will.
Yeah, but if they're little, you're going to be doing it.
Yeah, so you're not carrying it up the stairs. Well, it's already here.
You don't have to break your back and be out of breath like I was. Okay. And let's see what's over here. Another storage closet. Would you believe that? And then here's another bedroom. Faces the front of the property. Got these shutters. Nice tall ceilings.
And an ensuite bath.
Ensuite bathroom, which I didn't expect the closet to be this big.
Hold up. Check out the shower.
Got the penny tile. Oh, it's a pretty good size. And check out the closet.
Beautiful. Yeah, some homes in, like, I would say up to $700,000-$800,000 range, you could expect to see that size closet in the primary bedroom.
That's what I was thinking. Like, I did not expect it to be that big. No. I still can't get over like how massive this room is.
This is like literally,
it's huge.
Okay. Maybe not a football field, but like a pickleball court.
For sure, a full size pickleball court. Maybe even a little bigger. Okay. We have another full bathroom right here, and it's a dual purpose bathroom. It's the bathroom for whoever's hanging out in this family room, and it's also the bathroom for this bedroom right through this door. And then good size shower. And then might as well just pop in here through this door.
Jack and Jill situation.
Yes, Jack and Jill, but usually the Jack and Jill is sharing the two bedrooms. So this is like, and it is plumbed with the central vac. All the rooms are very generous size. This bedroom faces the backyard and also has a good size walk-in closet.
Folks, and this home is available for sale right now. So if you're watching this video, it is being filmed in September of 2024, and you'd like to find out more about this property with all of its closets,
yes,
the link is in the description below. If you would like to schedule a time for Michonne or myself to show it to you, our contact info is in the description below. I may be competing in looks department with Ray, but in terms of being the best realtor in Washington County, I'll give anybody a run for their money.
Yeah, no one said anything about being the
best. Except for Michonne. She's already grabbed that spot.
You're too kind. Okay, another bedroom with an ensuite bathroom. This bedroom faces the back of the property.
And this tile, I didn't even pay attention. It's like, it's nice and sparkly. I love it.
Oh, it is way cool.
And it has this matching little nook. It's got the shower tub combo and another good size walk-in closet. And I believe we have one more bedroom.
Ooh. It is a 6-bedroom house, right?
Yes, 6-bedroom and a 6.5 bathroom. So here is our last bedroom, faces the front of the property. Again, really good size. I love that the baseboards throughout the property are nice and high. That's a nice touch.
Yeah, those 6-inch baseboards are such a cool touch.
And the shutters, like this home's ready to go. The landscaping's beautiful.
It is a very, very premium house.
Walk-in closet, shower tub combo. And I think that does it for this property.
That concludes our tour.
Well, let us know what you guys thought. If you like this style of video, if you'd like to see more home tours, if you're interested in this property, please reach out to us. We would absolutely love to be of service to you. This is what $875,000 gets you in Crimson Boundaries. We are in the Crimson Vistas subdivision. This home is actually listed by Nick and myself. And this home is a 4-bedroom, 2.5 bathroom, 2,300 square feet on a 1/4 acre. There is a 6-car garage with a massive, is it 50 feet? Yeah, 50-foot deep RV garage.
One important thing about this RV garage, and anybody that's shopping right now that may already own an RV and knows their dimensions, or maybe you're buying a home to then later own an RV, look at that door. That door is 12 by 14 feet tall, and the ceilings in this garage are actually 20 feet tall. And the reason that's important is, of course, because you could fit pretty much anything that could legally go down the road and have some more extra space for storage up above.
And we should know because we've learned that the hard way. So
yes, we did.
We are your RV garage specialists when it comes to finding a home that fits your RV.
Do sell a lot of homes with RV garages. So if you guys have any questions in regard to that, we would love to answer them.
What do you guys think about, I know we're out inside the home now, but the modern two-tone texture of this home? I personally think that it pops a lot, you know, and I love the landscaping, the green, black with the white and black and gray, but I don't know, is this your guys' style? What do you think?
I think it's beautiful. Hey, can I steal the show for just 1 second while we're, you know, this video is about being in the right school boundaries. I want to point out one thing about this listing in particular, and it's actually directly across the street.
Kitty corner.
George Washington Academy is walking distance, like, you know, at a kid's pace, maybe a minute walk. It's literally right there. And as a kid, I always had to commute across town. How cool would that be for somebody to be able to live that close?
It's a very sought after school, and the school lines for drop off and pick up are ridiculous. So that would be a plus to live right here.
Yeah, what would it be like to not spend a half an hour to an hour in a school line?
Okay, so as we walk in, entryway is massive, which is awesome. And then right to the right of the front door, we have our first bedroom, or could be used as an office. There's French doors into this room. There's also exterior access to the front patio out this glass sliding door. How tall are these ceilings?
That's a good question. So these doors are 8 feet tall, so these ceilings are 12.
12, okay. Yeah, it makes a huge difference. And then good size closet. Okay. Let's see where the end of this entryway takes us. And the colors are just nice and bright and light. There are lots of windows to let a lot of natural light in. We've got this massive living area, family room,
with a huge kitchen and one of the biggest center islands I've personally seen in a home. Just especially like a 4-bedroom, 2.5-bathroom home. Like this is massive.
It is huge.
Huge. So this home is great for entertaining. This would be the perfect home for Thanksgiving and having all of your family over. We've got this huge, deep, single stainless steel sink, a 5-burner LG gas cooktop with a
pot filler.
With a pot filler. I'm like, why did I forget the name?
This is an added feature. So we've sold this plan several times for this builder. And this is probably the most upgraded that we have seen in execution of this plan. And our buyers love it.
It's beautiful. And I really love the knotty alder on the bottom and then this kind of cream white on top. And we've got our wall oven and microwave combo and an extra prep sink back here. Can be a little coffee bar and whatever you'd like in this huge pantry that's kind of tucked away around the corner.
Really cool. Somebody's a closet coffee drinker.
Right here in the closet. Okay.
And then, Utah joke.
Yeah. And then here is our dining area, which is pretty big. Could probably fit any table of your choice. And then we've got this gas fireplace, kind of modern looking, nice down low. This massive mantle up here that matches the cabinetry in the kitchen. And let's go check out the primary bedroom. Really good size primary bedroom with the tray ceilings, windows to the back.
And this property faces south, so your backyard faces north. If you want to put in a pool, that's kind of exactly what you want. So the backyard is never shaded.
It is on Dixie Power as well. And check out the size of this bathroom. I'm gonna shut this door. So we've got our dual vanity, some pretty cool shaped modern mirrors, our large soaking tub right here, privacy window, and a walk-in shower with two shower heads and a corner bench seat. Okay, and then we've got our water closet tucked away right here, and some more knotty alder cabinetry for extra storage. You never think you need all the storage, but you'll find when you're moving into a house that you'll end up filling it all up. So here is our walk-in closet. And one of my favorite features about this house is that you go in from the bathroom to this huge walk-in closet right into the laundry room. So you don't have to haul it across the house.
That is a very nice touch.
Very nice touch. And then we've got all of our bedrooms that will share this bathroom right here. So we've seen bedroom one, bedroom two, here's bedroom three. Good size. We've got a walk-in closet right here and bedroom four faces the front of the property and also a good size walk-in closet. And then just across the hall, we've got another full bathroom. Very good size. Behind the door, there's open shelving for your linens. And this shower tub combo with a really cool 3D texture tile.
Love it.
Now we are gonna go check out the massive, do you know how much square feet is in the garage?
Don't quote me on this. I will post a link in the description below. By the way, folks, if you're watching this video in early September of 2024, this home is available for purchase. And I will post a link in the description below this video with a full MLS listing. I want to say it's 1600 square feet, but I could be wrong.
That sounds about right. We've got a powder bath off the family room and kitchen. And then into the garage where you'll mostly be entering your house day in and day out. And we've got our 2-car garage right here.
Now, you know, another thing that's really cool about this garage. So this builder goes above and beyond and typically your garage walls are not insulated.
And you would be filling it by now, and it's toasty.
This home, the garage walls are fully insulated. So if you wanted to add like an HVAC unit, a mini split, something to keep this area cool or warm in the wintertime, you could totally do so. It is insulated just like the rest of the house.
Like, it feels really good in here. Yeah. And in the heat of the summer, it stays pretty cool in here.
Makes a huge difference in St. George.
Okay, look at this. What would you fill this up with? This is ridiculous. 50 feet. This is what 50 feet deep of RV garage space gives you.
It's absolutely massive.
And I like the four windows to let in some more natural light. All kinds of fun things that you could fill up this garage space with. But we haven't even gotten to the best part yet. Come check out the backyard.
It is a blank slate right now.
Which I personally like, because not everybody has the same wants and needs in their backyard.
Everybody's got different tastes. You might want to have a pool. You might want to have a pickleball court. You might want to have just gravel and no maintenance.
That's true. And then here is our exterior door back into the kitchen and family room. But let's go see. We've got this rear observation rooftop deck, which is my favorite feature. So let's go check it out. Come on up.
Hope I don't make you guys dizzy.
And there is a light switch at night, below and up top, that gives you a lighting to see the stairs and a light up here. And it is one of the coolest places to hang out in the evenings. And you just get some beautiful views of Pine Valley Mountain. The new Red Cliffs Temple glows and lights up at night, and it's absolutely gorgeous.
And I know that people will probably ask us in the comments for this video, so I'll just go ahead and answer it right away. Everywhere you see a green stub, there will be a house. There will be another street that will go in right there. So there will be most likely quarter acre lots. So you will have a neighbor that will back up with their backyard. Their house will face north. So you'll be sharing a backyard with somebody, but there's lots of privacy. I feel like these lots will actually give you plenty of space.
Yep. What do you guys think? What are your thoughts on this house? This is what $875,000 gets you in Crimson Boundaries, 4 bed, 2.5 bath, biggest garage ever. What do you think? Let us know in the comments.